mulligan. We're gonna keep this. We're gonna scry this on top. Gonna play Abby first, so that the scry land, the shadow land we draw, can come into play untapped. It's actually not intuitive at all to start with the Abby. And actually just only noticed because it was on top of my deck. But now that it happened, I know in the future that I should be playing my Abby and not my Forest. Alright, so he might be playing against a Black-Green Petition. Yep, very likely. I think we have to play Nissa here to be more mana efficient. And we get closer to ultimating it, which is probably pretty good in this matchup. Read the balance, fine. He puts a card on top and a card on the bottom. Oh, playing Gideon here would be so damn good. Gonna have to have it going to play tapped. Ruinous Path, the Nissa. Well, I guess we play Gideon now. Make it 2/2. So next turn we attack with Gideon, because it can't die to basically anything they have, and then we can minus it the following turn potentially. I suspect he's gonna languish that turn. Yep, languished happened. Inspector. Gonna crack a clue. Yeah, this card's not good. Attack for 5. I'm actually tempted to put a counter on it. He doesn't really have good ways to deal with it. He could Dark Petition for another Ruinous Path, I guess. Yeah. I'm not gonna put a counter. Yep, he's gonna Dark Petition for a Ruinous Path. Sad. Kind of have to just put a counter on my Revenant Inspector here. Like, this card's just gonna rot in my hand. Leap is good. Would have been even better a little bit earlier. But we have a lot of time in this matchup, and I think it's going to be very, very good. Although he's going to get to a point where it's going to start looping Season's Past. Omnixilis. Interesting. It's fine. Avacyn is nice. Although it dies to Grasp and dies to Grasp and Ultimate Price. I'm gonna attack him. Sure, we'll sack it. We got another Avacyn. It's kind of loose. advocate. I'm still better just playing Addison. Having a land would be nice. Would have been nice. So I can at least sack the Avicen when he kills it. Yep, that's fine. Tapped land. It's awful. Now I just play Advocate and he kills it. So maybe I just try to sneak the Avicen in again. Yeah, that's probably my line. As a removal. I mean, my goal is to try to run him out of removal, so hopefully that works. Yeah, I'll do that. Cool part is that I can get to a point where I just to the slaughter. I can get to a point where I can make tokens with Abby and start sacking them to my leap. Got Thraben Inspector. Sure, I have an emblem. Yeah. All right, it's gonna be hard to win. Secure the waste would still be insane. Kalidus. I play Inspector or Oath. With Oath, I can't get Secure the Waste. By getting Gideon with, let's say, Oath, I can activate it and make my Gideon fight the Kalidus, which is kind of nice. I'm actually going to try that. We'll get Hanger back. It's not good as long as Kalidus is in play, because it will be exiled. However, could probably find a workaround. Inspector, sack the clue. I guess I take damage doing that. Whatever. Pass. Or maybe we can sack it, and if I hit Advocate, I can replay it. If I get another Inspector, I can replay it. But I'll just wait for removal. Oh, so when he draws cards, I lose life too? I didn't know that. I might die more quickly than I thought. Take three. Yep. I'm down to nine. Sure, swamp is in play. Transgress resolves. So I can play Anger back for three, put a counter on it, have it fight Kalidus. Ooh, we drew Secure the Waste. Could that be enough? We can play for it seven. We can play it for seven. He's at seven. He's gonna gain three. So, but I can kill him with Abby actually. Yeah, I'm gonna try that. Why? Now I have to play it, and he's gonna play Languish. Yeah, I mean I have to try it, and I hope he doesn't have it, because otherwise I'm not gonna lose. I'm just gonna lose to Omnixilis. We need to be super lucky to win from here. Like, he needs to not have Languish or not have Dark Petition. I mean, it's very possible he kept the rest in his hand for that exact situation, which would be smart. Grasp. Maybe he doesn't have it. I mean, why would he not draw first? I think I should have kept. Yeah, I think I misplayed. I should have kept one mana up because I could block and then sack the token so that he doesn't gain three life. What? What just happened? Okay, so Omnixilis killed me, but I was at five. Oh, I didn't block. Oh my god. That was horrendously bad. Oh my god. Okay, so I didn't block. I went down to two, activated Omnixilis. So, if I blocked, he activates Omnixilis, gets to nine. Yeah, my play was horrible. I mean, it's clearly a misplay and a brain fart. I forgot about my life total, because obviously I basically never got attacked in this game. But yeah, this emblem got my life total pretty quickly, and not blocking here was horrible. So if I block, I have six tokens, and I can maybe tries to. Well, one thing he can do is not activate Omnixilis so that my Abby doesn't kill him, but then he has to deal with the Abby. So he would have probably gone for it, and if he didn't have Languish, then he dies. So I probably just threw away this game. We're gonna board these in. Secure the Waste is great. Although he's gonna have Virulent Plague. So that's something to be careful about. We can maybe board in Quarantine Field, but they have Naturalize. I'm kind of scared. We're about board out. Stasis Snare. Avacyn is not great. Dies to Ultimate Price and Grasp. And the flip side is not great in the matchup. Jamokas Command is not good, but it deals with Virulent Plague that we'll very likely have. So I'm gonna keep three and play this configuration of a deck. I'm gonna keep it just because I have Leap and it's so good in the matchup. I think I play Forest first. Forest, Plains, Leap. Nissa. Nissa's great with Leap. No Transgress. Dress. Oh, it's pretty much the same thing. It's not about that. It's the same thing. Yes, I'm sort of glad he didn't play it before, so that couldn't deal with the Leap. I'm playing Nissa. I totally expect it to die to Ruinous Path, but I still get a plant. Grasp the plant? That's not a good spot to be in. So I make a plant, then play Hanger back for two. Sounds decent. However, I can maybe just play it for one and then keep Leap up. Play like Oath, Anger back for one, keep Leap up. Nah, that's fine. If he kills Anger back, I get two Thopters and I can minus my Nissa. And if he kills the plant, well, obviously happy. And he concedes. I guess we're gonna play a third game. That was kind of a free win after I threw away game one. So now we're even. We're gonna play a real third game. This is a one lander. We're not gonna keep. This is reasonable. Do I want that? Not really. Kind of want to. It's sort of versatile, but I want to draw Leap, and Othernessa does not get it. Want to draw maybe Jamokas Command, and Othernessa is not going to get it. Alright, so in what order do I play these lands? Pretty sure this Canopy Vista is going to come into play tapped. No matter what, but I need in my hand for Fortified Village. So play the village, reveal the vista, and I'll play Inspector. Is he passing? Deadweight, that's aggressive. So I can play Advocate. I kind of feel like I should be keeping my Advocates in my hand because it doesn't die to Grass, but it might just die to Ultimate Price anyway. So holding to them is not the smartest. I can play Oath, try to hit my maybe a Nissa Voices Indicar. But I want to be playing on tap land no matter what. Play. I think I might just crack the clue. Now I'll play Advocate. Can't be right to crack the clue here. grasp is fine. And a swamp. Another canopy vista. So I can crack clue and play vista tapped and guarantee myself playing Gideon next turn. I kind of like that. Read the bones. Bottom top. I'll play another village. Forest. Play Gideon Superstar. Pass. Dark Petition for Ruinous Path, most likely. Hopefully our Earth Vanessa gives us another Gideon. Anissa. Yeah, I'll take Anissa. Can I play Gigantic? You're back next turn. Another Dark Petition. Virulent Plague. Alright, it's gonna be rough. We'll plus this because it doesn't do anything better. Play Anger back for 3. If it dies, it dies. If I could make it a 4-4, I would have put a counter on it to make it a 5-5, so it's protected from Grasp and Languish. Omnixilis. Alright. One plus Nissa. I don't think it's going to be able to survive until it ultimates, but who knows. Nope, it dies. That's gross. That's 2 plagues, so I'm not going to be able to make any tokens. Addison, maybe, is what we're looking for. Gideon is still good. Still a 5-5. And we'll take Addison. Yes. Kalidus. Sweet, sweet Avison that I expect it to be killed. As expected. Alright, we lost this game. I don't even know what I could draw. I guess I could draw Sigarda. I guess Quarantine Field would be insane in that spot. Yeah, maybe it's better in Dramoka's Command for the future. There's a bunch of cards I can actually draw and that they do something at this point, but he's so ahead on cards that he's just going to 1-4 on me and I'm going to die. And well, he's going to cast Seasons Past and start looping Nissa's Renewal. Garrus is fine. Avison. Maybe we won't be able to get that Kalidas. I don't think so. But who knows? Yeah, I'm just gonna concede at this point. Maybe he's like flooding, he only has lands, but I should not be winning this game, so I'd rather take the loss. To recap, obviously green white is great, I think. Virulent Plague is hard to deal with. I mean, it's not true. It's not hard to deal with because we have Dromoka's Command. But the difference is that they have Dark Petitions and Plague, so they technically have like six, and we only have a few commands, and our commands are terrible when they don't have it. So they just rot in our hand while they dress us. So I don't know who's the real winner. However, Leap is a great card in the matchup. I think it's pretty hard to lose when you have Leap. Gideon, just as a card itself, is great. Although they have Ruinous Path and they have 4 Dark Petition, so again, they might be the winner of this exchange. It's actually hard to know. I'll be playing more, obviously, and see if it's actually worth it to play green white in a metagame when people can Dark Petition into Virulent Plague. And I hope you find out as well. I'll see you next week.